Welcome to a demo of the C3 AI platform to accelerate storm surge modeling for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. A U.S. Army Corps of Engineers researcher wants to be able to easily model storms, quickly assess storm surge simulation data, and manage large downloads for further analysis. This application contains data related to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Coastal Storm Modeling System, CSTORM-MS. C3 AI integrated and unified six disparate types of CSTORM-MS data derived from historical extratropical storms for the entire U.S. Eastern Seaboard. The data integrated and unified included 1,050 tropical storm tracks, 6.4 billion water velocity records, 3.2 billion water elevation records, 6.3 billion atmospheric pressure records, and 7.2 billion wind velocity records. With this unified data foundation, some questions a U.S. Army Corps of Engineer user might want to answer are: emergency planning for a particular storm profile, is an area I care about flooded with storm surge? When does the storm surge begin, and when do I need to establish protective infrastructure? Disaster response: when does the storm surge subside? Engineering requirements: what are the requirements for protective infrastructure to prevent a storm surge in my area of interest? The AI and ML modeling capability approximates the results of physics models that run on supercomputers. A U.S. Army Corps of Engineers user can use this application to assess more storm surge model results in near real time. With this application, a new artificial intelligence and machine learning model can be run within 2 to 3 hours, an acceleration to augment supercomputer capabilities in specific circumstances. I am stationed at the United States Army Corps of Engineers Wilmington District Office with purview over the Outer Banks of North Carolina. We just received word of a new storm trajectory uploaded to the system. I log in to check whether my area is at risk of flooding from the storm surge. To do this, I want to quickly visualize storm surge simulation data that are representative of certain categories of storm, and then access and download the data to perform additional local analysis. I launch the application and see a blank map with a filter panel that I can use to narrow down my selection. The first thing I do is choose a storm that best fits my needs based on the storm track and closeness to the nodes I care about. I am concerned about the possibility of storm surge along the Outer Banks, roughly 35 degrees north, negative 76.12 degrees west, where protective infrastructure cannot handle more than half a meter of storm surge. To perform the analysis, I populate the map with a storm of interest and a series of mesh nodes that enable analysis of storm surge at specific locations. After applying the filter, I see a subset of the 3.1 million nodes relevant to this geographic region. I select a node in the region to view additional details such as latitude, longitude, the bathymetry, and the maximum expected water elevation at the point for storm number 3. Already I know that my protective infrastructure, which can protect against a maximum of half a meter of storm surge, will be insufficient to prevent surge during a storm like number 3. I want to know the details of storm surge at every moment during storm number 3 to better understand the severity of this surge. On the node details page, I see more details about storm number 3, such as the general heading, translation speed, the radius of max wind, and the maximum pressure. These statistics help me determine that the storm is relatively weak. I can view the full fidelity model time series, such as Cartesian winds and water velocity, surface pressure, and surface water elevation. By hovering my cursor over these time series graphs, I see that the storm reaches my node several days into the simulation. At that point, pressure drops, wind and water velocity increase, and storm surge rises. This gives me insight into when I need to have emergency infrastructure, such as sandbags, in place to protect against the surge. I see exactly the point at which the storm exceeds half a meter of storm surge, that is, above my protective infrastructure, and for exactly how long. I see the surge recedes relatively fast after the storm passes, which gives me insight into whether I can move first responders into position for disaster response. In just a few minutes on C3 AI, I managed to identify risks and develop a comprehensive timeline that will inform life-saving actions before, during, and after the storm surge. The This application, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers users can augment supercomputer capabilities with surrogate models that generate similar results faster. Quickly analyze billions of disparate storm surge data points from thousands of real and simulated storms. Instantly process and download insights and unlock value from new modeling tasks.